If any of you want, you can move up to the front row, but no obligation. Stay where you are. Can I ask you a few questions before we get started? Just by show of applause, actually. Can you applaud if you have been to an improv show before? And can you applaud if you have never been to an improv show before? Okay, so you all know what we're going to be doing here, all right? This is improv. We're going to be coming up with a story based on suggestions from you, the audience, and it's going to be entirely made up on the spot and never told again. This format that we're doing is called the hero's journey, so this is going to follow some hero as they go on an epic journey somewhere. But the somewhere is going to be actually decided by you, the audience. We have some cards here with genres on them. And you will pick a genre, and that will determine the genre of this show. We have spent some time warming up back there. You might have heard a little bit of it. But we want to help you guys get warmed up to give suggestions as well. So as a first, when I say go, can you just shout out your name? 3, 2, 1, go.
Cameron!
I heard Cameron. When I say go, can you shout out your favorite color? 3, 2, 1, go. And when I say go, can you shout out where you're from? 3, 2, 1.
Ohio.
In Seattle. Great. I think that's all the warm-up we need to do for you guys. One final thing. We're going to ask two of you to help us pick the genre, if that's okay. Or any two of you willing to just kind of pick some cards and then maybe pick a genre after we pick a few cards. Yeah? Woo! Alright, does anybody else want to help with this? Or great! Alright, so can you raise your hand, please? Alright, you are going to pick 3 cards from here. Okay, and can you read these cards out?
Okay, we have abstract, supernatural, and dystopian.
Abstract, supernatural, and dystopian. And now, you have the wonderful opportunity of choosing which of these genres we do for the show.
I'm going with abstract.
Oh my god. Let's go.
Thank you so much. There is one more thing I'm going to need from you all before we start this show. To clarify, an abstract show is something that kind of doesn't fit into any of the other genres that we have. So this one might be a little high concept or odd in some way. We'll see what happens. But the final thing we need before we can start the show, there's one more suggestion to get us started in the first scene. So, can you look at my hands here, and then just tell me one word for what I might be holding?
Basketball. A soccer ball.
Can you get bread. I heard bread.
Ooh.
All right, you got that bread. Okay, the SImps present
A Hero's Journey.
Dollars from
before.
Yes.
I don't see much
how was he? Did you notice any abnormal behaviors in the experimenter?
An experimenter?
Yes. When you tried to have him try again, did you notice any abnormal behaviors? Did you feel like anything was happening at all? That he was going to get some divine sense of inspiration or...
Oh, well... Yes, I will say... His bowels quirked a little bit right here.
Did you think it could be a sign of pity?
Pity?
Yes, did you think at any point he might be feeling some sort of connection?
Well, now I have thought of
it. Experiment.
But now that you say it, I think you might be right.
Alright. I want you to up the level of Kono 7 in his diet. Can you change that at the lunch tables? And do you do if you try prodding next time? Give him a little more. See if at any moment in his experimentation process he can find a connection to his subjects. Really.
I like this idea. It might just work.
Look tired.
Well, we've been doing this for...
Yes.
And it's just... I just don't know if this is the right way to do it. Make the experimenters the experiment.
How are we ever supposed to do anything in a way that's ethical if we don't know how best to practice ethics?
Well, yes, I suppose we could run simulations in that way in order to inform the way we live our lives, but... You don't think...
Experimenters that don't feel pity, that don't have any connection with their subjects, they're useless. They'll do torturous experiments that will drive their subjects crazy. I believe in what we're doing, and we're doing it for a purpose. It will be worth it in the end.
You don't think we're hurting them? You know what? Never mind.
No.
It's clear you have that same doubts.
No, not at all. I really believe this will work.
Mysterious thing. There's nothing to tell, even. You haven't even told us anything. I bet he's not even.
wish you would be more open.
You're right, another fatal flaw.
If we had some way of making his friends, maybe next time we could direct them to be need more probing questions, you know?
Yes. Well, they say they understand, but they're not very good actors, and humans are hard to control.
Yes, it's almost like they're actually becoming friends with them.
Makes the experiment very difficult to run.
You guys are sure you can't come hang out tonight again? Like, you certainly are able to hang out.
Yeah, we always have section rehearsal or dress rehearsal or run throughs or the conductor wants to see us individually
You musicians. I work way less in the lab than you guys do.
We're underpaid.
It's the art too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Underpaid? She's directing that at us.
Telling you, fickle.
It took her forever to get the chairs in the right position.
You know what's really frustrating? Is that I feel that the conductor, you know, they're trying to get this beautiful music out of us, but like, we don't even get paid anything to like, write the really probing music, you know? And do the really great, great execution that like, we could if we were paid more so that we could practice for longer.
Don't you think you could actually bring something great to life?
Yeah.
What's really probing music? I've never heard music described that way.
Oh, you science people just don't understand.
Okay.
Right?
Is it like, you know?
It's just the right side of the brain ain't working for y'all.
Yeah. Those left brainers, they really gotta understand that, you know, acting the music out, it takes a lot out of
looking into it, feeling it, creating it.
Yeah. See, Penelope's got a gift. You know, but she just can't share it with you or the world.
I mean, if only we were actually compensated.
Yeah.
So you can hang out at Chili's more, maybe.
Yeah.
I'd love to hang out at Chili's more.
Yeah.
Do you guys take out with it?
Yeah, we do. It's great. You just put it up to the scanner right there.
Boink.
Perfect. And that's where you hear C.
Thank you.
Have a lovely day.
Huh?
I said have a lovely day.
messed up your day?
Yeah. I forget sometimes. I'm very forgetful.
Okay, well, thank you, Penelope.
Bye.
Boss, this is serious. she reported some stupid bug?
Yes. She got a raise. We're gonna raise the poster finally. It's. I mean it. We're going to push forward into a further level. More time, more everything.
Okay, yeah, because I am expecting my money.
Yes.
We're doing the same job.
Yes. Everything will be ramping up very shortly.
You alright, boss?
This. Something hit me while I was watching. Your conversation. It's. I can't quite place it. But. I found it unsettling the way he was expressing his. The things he was saying about his experiment, they just reminded me of something, I don't know what.
His frustration is control.
Yes, frustration, control. It was like everything that he was feeling about him. The creature is what I feel every single day when things go wrong.
You're doing the same thing.
Bing-a-ding. Hey, Angelica. I'm ready to pick up some wet cloths from Walmart. Wondering if you want me to grab you anything. You can come if you... So just let me know.
What is that?
Oh, just a text.
Just a text? What did it say?
Oh, you know, just a text. You don't get to read my texts unless you pay me more.
All right. Well, why don't you get off of my office then?
With pleasure. Come pick me up.
Breakthrough I want to have with these creatures I'm creating,
mm-hmm.
Right? I'm just thinking, like, you know, maybe you can't, like, fully control it. I don't know. Maybe I need to use, like, electricity or, like, something to, like, punish it, you know? Like, because it's going to do wrong things. We got to, like, kind of punish it when it does, right?
Maybe that's not a great idea.
Whoa. Is there nobody in here?
It's always empty in here, I think.
What are you talking about? It's Walmart.
Yeah, no, it's always empty on Fridays. Hello. Welcome to Walmart.
You were not here just 2 seconds. Well,
sorry, I was in the back. That's normal when the day breaks.
Yeah, but not everybody in the store. Can I like talk to your manager or something?
My manager is out. Bradley, it's fine.
Look, what is going on here? I'm gonna go to this back that you speak of, alright?
Sorry, sir. Bradley, I wouldn't do that. Bradley, we cannot allow customers in the back. You go back in.
Oh, look, nobody here in the produce section. Nobody needs produce.
Oh god, where'd he go? Bradley, you really shouldn't. Bradley, don't go looking where you don't want to find out, okay?
Please, sir.
Bradley, you know how you were talking about wanting to hurt the things in your experiment?
Yeah.
I don't
think other people think how I think. I think that's...
Yeah. Oh, Bradley, you don't want to find out what's going on, okay, Bradley?
Look, it says employees only. That's fine.
Please, Bradley.
Bradley,
I have to find out.
Okay?
I'm trying to be level-headed. I was with Angelica, and she received some sort of text message on her phone during our conversation. It was like a little beeping, and she wouldn't say what it was, but it was as if she was getting commands from a higher layer. I don't want to sound crazy or
you're sounding crazy right now.
But there was this connection that I was feeling, as if the same experiment we were running might be running, being run on me. And I looked at the cameras and I was trying to see if any of the glass in the room might be reflected or see through.
Conrad! You sound like one of the experimentees. You sound deranged. Is this because Bradley is figuring things out? Huh? I know. It's a flipping experiment. It's bad.
Figuring things out.
Well, you can get the news report.
In my office.
Hello? Any managers? God, maybe the working conditions. I'm here looking for the manager.
The Baron, Madam Baron?
Huh?
Huh? What manager are you talking about?
Yeah, I'm looking for...
Do you know how long I've been out again?
Well, there's nobody out there, so probably a while.
Oh, shit, I was supposed to fill it with people.
Okay. The back of the Walmart is like, shit, it's so far. Okay.
You're gonna need to go, like, oh god, okay, this is like the basement floor of like a really tall building. You can't see it from like the outside of the Walmart, because it's like that, what's it called, like a plexiglass? I don't remember.
Yeah.
They're, the highest higher up?
Yeah, like the, whoever, you know, started all this.
Dang, okay. Should be on like, I want to say like the 30th floor?
Alright.
Yeah.
You can take this elevator?
Yeah, that should work.
Maybe I should, you know, I'll bring your lab coat to the washing machine on the other floor.
Oh shit, thanks man!
Yeah.
Come visit me in the back rooms anytime.
Cool, we'll do.
You know, whenever I regret selling our son to this experiment, I just... the 1950. Shall I get the glasses?
Yes.
It's nice that they keep us on this floor so we can watch them on the screen.
It's the anniversary, isn't it?
I'm getting close to birthday. Yeah.
You're gonna pour me.
Thank you.
Gotta wonder how he's doing.
Oh, I'm sure he's doing fine. I mean, it's an experiment, it's ethical.
You were sure, well, and now you're there.
Yes, that's true. And he's doing what he always wanted, you know, creating life.
Yeah.
We're really good parents.
Cheers to that.
That child. You remember how he would cry? But not because babies, you know, not the reason babies usually cry. No, because he didn't know things.
Yeah.
He didn't know what he wanted to know, the puzzle piece.
Oh yeah, the same puzzle piece.
Oh, and remember that.
Oh, remember when he got so angry because the color on the box of the puzzle was slightly different than the actual puzzle? Oh, that was infuriating.
Oh, he's better off than that one.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he thinks he has some control over his life.
Explain something to me right now. Am I, are they, like if I was like a puppet, right? Are they?
No, you got free will. Fortunately, yeah, we can't.
Okay. Consolation prize?
Consolation prize? I mean, you weren't saying that when you were working at the lab, were you?
Uh-huh. So, just, okay. Every time I've been going to Walmart, I've been being watched. That's what you're saying? Like every time I like did something embarrassing in the aisles, like you're saying that like for that whole time I've been being watched?
You think it's just Walmart?
And Angelica, is she here?
Hey, Sylvia, I got your text.
Thank God. Oh, my God. Come in. You. Yeah, that's the trouble I've been dealing with.
I told you, you'd be happier if you just did what I said. Yeah, oh, my God. Sorry.
You came with me to this Walmart. You know I could...
Yeah, I guess I would have physically held you back, but they don't pay us that much.
I need to sit down.
You have to get this model done by midnight.
Oh, by midnight they're making you?
Well, and now I gotta deal with this. Do you know what she's gonna say?
She's gonna say, wow, you're not gonna get that money till later.
I worked hard for that raise.
Yeah, well, you didn't work that hard, frankly.
Did you guys not go to Peru last week?
Wow. You're supposed to be like a scientist.
Yeah, Occam's razor. The simplest truth. I assume if you tell me you're going to Peru, you're going to Peru.
Not this! Right. Because two musicians. Even if musicians get to go to Peru whenever they want.
Okay, musicians, yeah. Tell me about that. You guys ever...
Oh, we just knew you didn't know anything about it. So, like, profession that we could talk about, only two that you didn't know things about it. We're actors. We take our craft seriously. That part was true. Yeah.
Is the fluge even real?
Actually, I don't hate one, but I don't know.
Yeah, Sylvia's great at tinkering as well.
I think the models would have known things I heard.
Yep.
Thank you.
I help with publicity, you know? Gotta believe that the experiment is ethical. Especially if your parents are gonna keep.
Okay. This is fun. And how are we gonna fix this, okay? I need to talk to your guys' boss. I need to.
Pretty a gem, I am. I'd be down to bring you to them, but they ask us if we don't go to them. Waiting corridors are so long.
Hey, Sylvia, can I talk to you for a second?
Yeah, sure.
You know, if we bring him to them. Big payday.
Oh my God, you're so right.
Yeah. So we're his friends. Remember emotional connection. Yeah.
So we went to his friend and then bring him to story. Okay.
And he believed it before, so.
He's gonna leave by then.
Oh, those bosses, they don't pay us enough.
They really don't pay us enough.
They don't pay us enough. Wow.
Make them all by midnight?
That's ridiculous.
No, we're gonna help you get out.
They're not our real friends. Bradley is our real friend.
Right?
Yeah.
He listened to us.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Just
we'll take you.
Okay.
We'll take you off the elevator before.
Absolutely not. You want to electrocute him. Now he's out of the world.
It's the only way.
Connor, you're going increasingly erratic.
No, I'm not going erratic. I'm not going erratic. I tried to drive home today. I haven't been home in weeks. I haven't been home in weeks. Because I was focused on the experiment. And I found the freeway. It was close. Reconstruction.
Construction.
So I drove right back. I tried to call home, and you know what? Busy city.
Connor, you're a scientist who spends most of your time with your experiments.
I don't want to be a scientist anymore. I want out.
Out where?
Out somewhere. Outside. Out anywhere. Anywhere from here.
You can leave anytime you want. You're not trapped here. You're not in an experiment.
You know. Never
across your mind? No fear, no little inkling of anything? It's never crossed your mind.
Don't be silly. Why are you looking at me like that? Oh, you're suspecting me, aren't you? Oh, you're such a scientist. This is the real world, Conrad.
How many sisters do you have?
You know how.
How many sisters do you have?
Two.
Your mother, her hair color.
Brown. What is this? Why are you carrying me?
As a child, was it third grade or fourth grade where you learned your multiplication tables?
Third. The second week of June. Listen.
You remember that you learned your multiplication tables in the second week of June of your third grade? That's oddly specific. I hardly remember anything.
Conrad, we've been calling for years!
I hardly remember anything from third grade!
You can't be so
stuck here. I am.
I'm gonna
find a way out of here.
Just try. You'll go mad.
Conrad. It's time to go to sleep.
I'm telling you guys, we need to take a diversion here. This is where the lab is, right? I just need to pick up a few things.
Alright.
Maybe quick.
Yeah.
Wait outside, I guess.
You know?
Sure. It's wheat. Feral but non-violent, 3 cups of phosphorus. And this one, very, very violent and deadly, 2 cups of nitrate.
Here, Bradley.
And just increase their diet. More sugar. Doesn't even follow my fingers.
Did that have to say before?
Bradley needs to go back home.
If we disable it, then the bosses won't be happy.
They will.
Yeah.
This way, are we going to have to get into the elevator?
Oh, but what if your experiment got a little messy and your subject here maybe accidentally, messed with some of the things here.
And I don't know how sure I really want that was.
Bradley, if you don't go back home, you will have to go to sleep.
That was creepy. I'm gonna read my science book and maybe you guys can talk about how to beat that thing. Talking about this.
I'm not sure if you heard the PSA, my man, but if this isn't the only layer, how do you think we're gonna get punished with bad attitudes?
Yeah, did you? I mean, did you hear them screaming? It sounded pretty painful.
Until you realize there is only us. person?
Can't tell. What's our matter here? It won't be long before you're mine.
This was a person.
Just waiting for the moment.
This was a person.
See, you've already lasted longer than the last one.
You know, yeah, you might be the leader of this experiment in an increasingly high level of experiment. You might think you know everything, or you might think that someone far above you knows everything. There's one thing that I know, okay? And it's about people.
What? There's nothing to know about people.
People.
People
like bread. Yeah, you can do all your experiments and you wouldn't find that one. That truth of reality.
You are a strange specimen, I will admit. No one's come up to that conclusion before, but I don't see how it leads anywhere. What are you doing?
I'm bringing Alvin here. Sorry, people, that you thought it was fine to experiment on.
What do you mean? Into, not to this layer of the building. They can't sustain all of them.
Wait,
and
we
take care of them. They're disposed of.
And I don't think you know very much about my experiments. All right? But I have a lot of bread.
Unusual subject reaction. It's not unusual at all. What are you doing?
And I don't care. I don't care if I have to do this 100 more times.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Invoke empathy to create ethical experimentation. And
The only person who'd be truly committed to that would have to make sure the experiment was ethical. There's only one subject that they would ever allow to undergo such torture. Themselves.
Go on.
Tomorrow, and the same set of schedules as next week as well.